What's up, guys? Me, Kiki Solano, welcoming you to BYUSN right now. Sorry, a little stress watching the end of the women's game. Wait, what? I needed this. Woo! I'm clearly so hyped about women's basketball, and rightfully so, but, you know, before we get into all the good things from this weekend, the amazing win from our girls, I actually should probably just start with the loss from this weekend. Let me go to the desk for this. BYU men's basketball fell 73-62 to 11 seed UCLA on the road Saturday night, knocking us out in the first round of the NCAA tournament. If that just isn't enough pain for you, here's some more. This is our first back-to-back loss in the Pope era. I feel like I need to throw something. Yeah, that's helping. We didn't have a single lead the whole game, so that is great. And Matt Harms announced he's not coming back. It is okay though, we're gonna celebrate what this team has done this season later. I need to process this first. Now let's get to some BYU dubs. BYU women's basketball takes down Rutgers 69-66 in the first round of the NCAA tournament. This is the first time a lower seed has taken down a higher seed in the women's tourney so far this year. It was a dramatic game coming down to the final moments, but our girls got it done. In large part thanks to Paisley Johnson-Harding, who tied her season high with 28 points. She couldn't be stopped, you guys. Oh, this game was so epic, they deserve to celebrate big. The girls aren't done yet though. Next up, they're taking on three seed Arizona on Wednesday. More Kiki Karma for them. Say hello to your 2021 Mountain Rim Gymnastics Conference champs, number 12 BYU Gymnastics. This after the girls put up a 196.925 on the road in Logan on Saturday. The girls have now won this title back to back. But you know, MRGC team champs just wasn't enough for them. Let's not forget that our gymnasts have also earned their seeding for the NCAA tourney. The girls are a 12 seed and will compete in a quad meet against 5 seed Cal as well as Ohio State and Towson in the Morgantown Regional. As for number 2 BYU men's volleyball, our guys finished off their road series right versus number 4 Pepperdine, getting the sweep against the Waves. Gabby Garcia Fernandez led the match, getting 12 kills while hitting 364. Oh, and he had 4 blocks. So while I'm sure he was enjoying his weekend, well, based off these pictures, the rest of the team was too. Yeah, they were literally doing well against the Waves. Men's volleyball wasn't the only ones getting the sweep this weekend. So did number 16 BYU women's volleyball versus number 21 San Diego on our home court. Kennedy Eschenberg and Whitney Bauer swept the weekly conference awards as well. Kennedy earning herself WCC Defensive Player of the Week and Whitney as Offensive Player of the Week. And the wins just keep on coming. Number 17 BYU women's soccer took down Pacific 5-1 on the road. 2 goals came from Rachel McCarthy, 2 from Bella Foligno, and 1 from Brecken Merzingo. And 2 of those 5 goals came within 1 minute of each other. Actually, 46 seconds if we want to get specific. Now that is insane. You know what doesn't seem insane at this point? Michaela Coulihan getting awards. It's still a big deal, so I want to wish Kayla a big congrats on earning herself National Player of the Week by College Soccer News. Congrats, Kayla. And believe it or not, we are still not done yet. Our Batcats finished their first weekend of WCC play the right way, sweeping LMU on the road, winning 9-2 on Friday and 4-1 on Saturday. Now this is the type of momentum we want before tomorrow's home season opener versus UVU. Now that I'm in a good mood from all of those dubs, I think I can finally give BYU basketball the goodbye it deserves for the season. Because while, yes, it is sad that BYU men's hoops ended on the note, That they did. We have to honor everything they accomplished.
This team accomplished incredible things. You know, they're walking out of this season with a pocket full of records and incredible accomplishments and huge contributions to BYU basketball. But at the end of the day, they got something that's way deeper and way more important than any of those things. They got each other.
Thanks to men's basketball for a great season, and thank you guys for hanging out with me on BYUSN right now. Go and give us the follow, and I will see you guys next time. Peace out.